The odds, with centuries of conflict surrounding its development and growth.
Yet, not only has the English language survived, it has also triumphed. The language of a small island rose to become the language of a commonwealth, the conquering tongue of myriad cultures and histories.
Today, English is recognised globally, and also is known as a first or second language.
Sure!
Where does our story begin?
Dialects of the Germanic tribes,
who settled in Britain during the 5th century using the Old Celt language, which we now call Old English.
Next came were the missionaries bringing with the manuscripts written in Latin. Such was the influence of not just religion but learning, that religious monasteries became places in which monks became fluent in reading and writing in Latin.
By the 7th century, the simple relica and concilia meeting was born.
When all was left in England, English came to be known as the language of peasants.
However, Old English simply adapted and expanded, evolving up until the Middle English of the 14th and 15th centuries, with the writers of such redoubtable authors such as Geoffrey Chaucer and Sir Thomas Malory.
William Caxton's printing press in the Renaissance period pushed language still further forward into the early English modern period. Where Shakespeare's words echoed around the theatre.
Finally, the Industrial Revolution and the Age of Imperialism spread English around the world, giving rise to different dialects.
English never been a small stagnant language, and in the 21st century continues to flex muscles.
While many of us mourn once familiar words such as seldom, which is now seldom used, we have little choice but to embrace or adapt to the language of today.
The invention of the internet and mobile phones created many new words, for example, lol, which made it into the vocabulary of the English world.
The future of the English language is unpredictable. Will standard English stand the test of time against the modern language of next speak or text speak?
Whatever happens in the future, the rich and unrivalled history of the English language deserves to be lauded, its story to be told.
Good afternoon, Britain! Welcome to Timeline News at 2 o'clock. I'm Angela.
And I'm Saxon.
And we're Anglo-Saxon! Now, normally, we would be giving you your usual stories, such as the world's largest Kit Kat being discovered. But we're not going to do that, because this afternoon, we have a special broadcast for you. We're here to bring you...
The Art of the English Language.
Thank you, Saxon. Now, it should be noted that the English language is a vast market of words that were either created, borrowed, or handed down. How many words?
2,000.
Maybe even more than 2,000.
Exactly.
Why do you think this is, Saxon?
Some of the words might have been borrowed or handed down through generations.
Ah, like they've entered in various ways.
Yes.
Would that explain why the language itself isn't all purely English? Because they've come from different eras.
Yes.
We now go live to our historical performers to bring you the Art of the English Language. We will return later on for another broadcast.
Is black. It stinks. My mind, once filled with dreams of beauty, is now a furnace of revenge. 3 years ago, when I was born, I laughed with joy at the heat of the sun. I cried at the call of the birds. The world was a cornucopia to me. Now it is a waste of frost and snow. The
son becomes the father, the master, the slave. I have led him over the Black Sea, through Tartary and Russia. I have led him past the Archangel and out onto the ice. We go north, always north. His dogs are dead. His supplies exhausted. But we have a compact we must keep. He lives for my destruction. I live to lead him on. Frankenstein! Come. What is the matter? Are you cold? Do you feel forsaken? Come, great explorer. Look, there is food. Seal meat. Explorer's food. You wanted power. Look at you. Immortality. Look at you! Why did you treat me like a criminal?
You killed my wife!
You killed mine, Frankenstein.
You brought this upon yourself.
Did I? How? How did I? Did I ask to be created? Did I ask you to make me out of some muck in a sack? I am not normal. I know I am different. I have tried to be the same, but I am different. Why can I not be who I am? Why does humanity detest me? The only one to show me pity was Elizabeth. Lovely Elizabeth. I can still taste her lips, her strawberry lips. I can feel her warm breasts, her thighs. Frankenstein, I know what I have done.
Talking crap cooking, I'm talking bird. So I've been chatting to this lass, right, and well, you know. She's a bit shy and that, but I've been talking to her and she sounds banging. But I am banged yet, cause she don't really know who I am. But I'll give her a bell now, I'll give her a bell for you. I warn you now that my chat up lines are top notch. So lads, get your notepads out. Shit. I need to go put some romantic tunes on, just give us a sec. Shut the fuck up, dickhead, I'm on the phone.
Welcome to View Cinema.
Shut up,
say.
Oh.
Now then.
Please select one of the following. Film times, ticket bookings, or general inquiries.
Well, that's up to you now, Dal. Whatever tickles your fancy.
Sorry, I didn't catch that.
Ticket bookings, love. Ticket bookings.
Okay, please select a location.
Did you hear that? She wants to know where I live. She is in to me. Or I'll be in to her. Ull.
Sorry, did you say oral?
No, but I'll give you oral anytime, babe.
Sorry, I didn't catch that.
Ull, love. Ull.
Did you say hove?
Right, listen here, our kid. I'm trusting you. She's gone a bit shy on me. So what I need you to do is just say ull down firm for me. Now, I don't want any of this playing business. I know what you Spice Boys are like.
What do I say, ull? Ull?
Alright, that's enough fucking hell.
You selected hove. Please select a film or say what's on.
What's on? What is on? I know what's on. Me. Because you turned me on.
Did you say Terminator?
No. Suck my cock.
Was that Hancock?
No, but you can answer my cock anytime, babe.
You selected the film Babe.
She needs to go left. Left!
I'm going left.
You know you need to go left there.
I'm going left, I can't go any more left.
Right, and Jess, you need to go right and get them coins, yeah?
Yeah, I'll go right.
You need to go a bit further.
Alright.
What are you doing? What are you actually doing?
I'm going right, you told me to go right.
I didn't mean right, go a bit right there.
Oh, look, he's at the tower. Yeah, I'm going.
You can't sleep me. We're in the middle of a mission. What are you doing?
I'm gonna go. You get really aggressive.
I'm not being aggressive. I just need to get the coins.
We've got our exams in a week. We need to go revise.
They're fine. Come on.
Do you guys want to revise then?
Yeah.
Alright, come to man. Alright, I'll see you later.
Offline.
Look off.
What?
She hasn't been off it.
Oh, I don't even care. But... Where's my folder?
Which folder?
A blue one.
It's at Emma's.
Oh, yay. Come with me.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
3 days. Do you think she's even had a wash?
Probably not.
Imagine the smell.
But please, come with me. I'm not going there, babe.
Fine, but I'm taking disinfectant.
It's a good idea.
Come on. What are you actually doing? What are you doing?
Can you hear a noise?
Like a sort of tapping.
She's not still on it.
I see. Oh, jeez.
Emma?
English folder.
Yeah. Emma!
What are you doing? I'm asking to do that lever!
You know you've been on this for 3 days.
Have you eaten? Well, you have, but... anything, healthy? Yeah, actually, press at them, yeah? Don't pass at them!
Oh, there's something dead in there!
Fine!
Oh, I can't be in here, I feel sick. Oh, look, I'll see you later, Emma.
I'm going to offer you a last chance, you know, to get off the game and everything. Last chance?
I'm Emma, I'm 22 and I've not left the house in 3 years. I spend my days gaming and eating junk food. I'm addicted to Facebook. I wish my life was different, but I love technology too much.
That sounds great.
Can we invite Emma?
Emma?
Yeah.
I don't know, it's been years.
Well, she hasn't changed that much. She's just got a bit fat.
Fat?
Yeah.
Still gaming?
Yeah.
Look, you can do what you want with her, but I've had enough of her. We tried to help and she's just not listening.
All right.
Well, I'll text you tomorrow or something, all right?
Yeah.
I'll see you later.
Bye. Jess, it's me.
Who's me?
It's Emma.
Oh, right. Hi.
Hi, you alright?
Yeah, you alright?
Yeah, not bad. I was actually just ringing to ask you something.
Go on.
I don't know what to do. There's a bit of a problem at my house. I mean...
What sort of problem?
Everything's just gone off. Like, the power and everything's just gone.
So you're ringing me to say that your electricity's gone out?
Not quite, no. I don't know if there's something wrong with it, the power cut or anything like that, but...
Have you paid your bill?
I think so.
That means no, right?
Maybe, I mean, it's been ages, so...
Well, what did you ever do for me and Louise, really? Did you ever help us? Did you ever get off the game?
Come on, Jess, we're friends, aren't we? I mean...
You said we were friends, yeah.
Yeah, but we are.
I'm sorry, I'm not going to help you.
Sleeve like a big deal.
This lad has just sold with this new kind of soap. It's called Life Boy and it smells of mint and it's so shaggy, right? It makes you mad absolutely.
Rawr.
Wild. Every piece contains 125 mint leaves in it. In it? You never smelled out like this before. It smells banging and so will you. It's called Life Boy. It smells of mint and it's so tangy it will make you mad.
Rawr.
Wild.
that's just wrong.
Oh no, I'm fine.
That kind of language sends shivers down my spine. Mm. I can't stand this ongoing toleration with abbreviation.
Yeah.
I mean, HMV felt the need to abbreviate, and that's why I never set foot into their premises.
That's why they went out of business. Look, Rupert, we was laughing out loud.
I mean, how illiterate do you have to abbreviate yourself laughing out loud? Which, may I add, is a complete lie. These people do not laugh out loud, they snigger.
Too true. You know, once I witnessed a man texting Waffle, that's the funniest thing ever, yet I did not see this man rolling around on the floor laughing.
I feel sick.
Rupert, drink some tea.
No, it's all right. It's just, you know, talked about...
What?
Abbreviation.
Oh, God!
Look, there's a picture of a girl on the front of a paper with the heading Totes Emoche. Apparently, she had plastic surgery done to her face and she was happy with the results, but I mean, how could they tell? She'd always look surprised.
Shouldn't this word abbreviation be classed as a disability anyway? I mean, also, why is it such a long word? That's just very contradictive.
All those questions will never have any answers, those poor questions. Whatever happened to proper English, Derek? I wish I could speak it, really. Henry V would have shed a tear if he heard about what I had to endure. The Queen would say, "One is rather distressed." I can hear her now. Yes.
I think those teenagers.
No.
Youths.
No.
Little parasites. Should not be allowed to step foot out of their household until they have read the dictionary thoroughly. Because it did take 44 years to write. Let's make it worth writing.
Yes.
I would make them eat it if that's what it takes.
Alphabet spaghetti has its uses, Derek. Derek. I was shopping within the early hours of this morning when my ears were hit by what I only can describe as a verbal monstrosity.
What happened?
A group of teenagers.
No.
Youths?
No.
Miniature Adolf Hitlers were in my vicinity when they structured an ill-mannered sentence using abbreviated words. I was absolutely disgusted, to say the least.
Oh my.
I did not think trying to buy Lady Gaga's new album would be such a troublesome task.
That sounds terrible. Lady Gaga?
Yes, Lady Gaga has inspired me in so many ways. I married the night and became an evening shopper.
Of course.
But then again, I was probably born this way.
That sounds fascinating.
Anyway, my complaints to the customer service desk only aggravated the situation when one of the yobs overheard me and threatened to serve me, in which I replied, "I'm not hungry."
Wait, these yobs type people, they threatened to serve you at that time in the morning? That's an abomination.
The next part is quite graphic, Derek, so please brace oneself.
And brace, Rupert.
I have to brace too. Okay. I had to explain to the staff that I was put under a lot of stress after hearing, and I quote, "My GF had her growler out. It looked like an Afro child. But then again, YOLO."
I'm gobsmacked.
The last part makes me feel physically sick. But it's okay, Derek. I'm gonna go from sleepless days and nights to this toleration of abbreviation is abolished!
Right, Rupert, because... YOLO. High five. Don't leave me hanging.
No.
Oh, you what? Bet you're wondering who I am. Oh my. That's a good question. Let's not dwell on that for now. You see, there are a lot of things in this world that really annoy me. And one of them is people's perception and misunderstanding of the English language. See, the English language is a very, very powerful tool. And not a lot of people can successfully wield this tool. Most people just whip it around like bleeding lunatics. That annoys me. But aside from that, I'm actually here for a reason. Maybe I'm here for another reason. Maybe I'm not even supposed to be here. Son of a gun, I've got it. Now, who can tell me what son of a gun means? How about you? You know what son of a gun means? Huh? Okay. How about you, mum? You know what son of a gun means? No. Fair enough. Son of a gun was actually derived from when sailors would go across the Atlantic Ocean to the West. That's not right. West Indies. And take, more like kidnap, some of the native women. And they would have their way over them between the cannons. And some of these native women would become pregnant, and the sons of these native women would be referred to as the sons between the guns, thus the phrase son of a gun. Now, I actually got arrested a few years back for not following the rule of thumb, which clearly dictates that I could beat my wife with anything that was a similar size or diameter or smaller than the diameter of my thumb. But I didn't follow that rule. And that's the rule of thumb. But me bringing that rule up, some people would say that I was crazy. Or maybe as mad as a hatter. And I would call those people fools. Because hatters went mad because of the smell of the very powerful adhesive glue that they used when sticking hats together. How I miss the smell of glue. But I'm not as mad as no hatter.
Exactly that. I tried eating pickled eggs.
It'll take a lot more than that to knock him off his stride. Seriously, you want to beat one of these lemurs, you've got to become a shouter.
Just shout out like he's in the next state.
Thanks, I'll give it a go. Thank you.
All right, give it a red dot crack, mate.
Hooroo! Your uncle was a spacer, mate. Your auntie was a shouter. Foster's.
My brother has invited an acquaintance of his to a dinner party which will be hosted by my husband and I, but he talks constantly and has no understanding of spatial awareness.
Oh, the noisy rascal!
Oh, do you mean he invades space? Like a space invader?
Yes, what shall I do?
Just keep offering him a couple of Foster's beers and nibbles. A way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
Oh, thank you both so very much.
Oh, you're most welcome, dearest.
Yes, dear.
Goodbye.
Foster's beer. It saves the day. Oh, I say.
Yeah.
just money and up of awkward. Pick up in the crate, he then pushes them away. And then they would all talk like, where's the hair of Vikings? Bring my words to you. Scare, anger, and many more. By 1066, the love's been long and began speaking French while I didn't know what. So the Rogers were like, bonjour, ça va madame. They would reply,
show off that beautiful smile of yours, will you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and don't wear wear any of that revealing stuff you tend to wear. No one likes revealing.
All right.
And them lady lumps are for milking and nothing else.
All right, Gran.
Is that boy coming that you like?
Maybe.
Oh. Well, you just remember how me and your granddad
Gran,
met back
Gran
when they had
time.
Respect, you know, in the olden days. Hello? 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 Look, Sophie! Hello? Hello? So, well, I love you. Bye.
You grand.
Bye. Yeah, she keeps trying to tell me where her and Granda got together.
Oh, it's cute.
It's not. It's really boring.
Billy. Hello, Billy. You don't know who I am, do you? I'm your conscience, Billy. You're going on a date tonight, aren't you? But you don't know the first thing about courting, do you? Okay. Tip one. Always bring the lucky lady flowers. Without the vase, Billy. Tip two. Speak with confidence.
Hi!
Little lower, Billy.
Hi!
Silly, Billy. Shall we try that again?
Yeah.
Okay, tip two. Speak with confidence.
Hi!
Little quieter.
Hi!
A bit louder.
Hi!
Perfect. Now, tip three. Compliment the lady.
Oh, you look lovely!
Little less calm, Billy.
You look lovely!
You look lovely.
Perfect. That's the ticket. And finally, tip five.
Four!
Four! Tip five.
I got it. You feel less frightening, Billy? Perfect. And you're on your way. Good luck, Billy. Bye.
See ya.
Stand tall, head up, and be ladylike.
That's the ticket. Right. Sorry, darling. Just a little bit too much. Right. Now, let's sort this dress out. It's a little bit tight. Let me
Mother,
just...
Mother, please.
Okay. You do look beautiful. Head's a gentleman.
Is he handsome?
I'm sure he will be. Right, are you ready to go? We don't want to keep him waiting. Eldest William.
Hello, William.
Go on then.
Thank you.
Oh. We'll just leave you two alone.
Yes, I'll be at the bar with your father. Have fun, you two.
How are you?
Oh dear, Billy. You've forgotten to speak, haven't you? Just say something. Anything will do.
Mothers, they're so pushy.
Joke, Billy. Laugh at her. Laugh! Billy, this isn't
working. Just do something normal. Tip three, Billy. Remember tip three.
Your hair looks like trees and your eyes look like spiders.
Billy, you can turn this around. Go get her. Be confident. Confident, Billy. Get him out of the way. Ask her for a drink.
Excuse me.
Ask her for a drink.
Do you want to go drink?
Billy, ask her again.
Drink.
Yeah.
She said yes. Welcome, Billy. I'm going now because you're useless. Good luck.
Yeah, so do you think he'll make it?
Oh, you know, I don't know. I'm terribly busy, you know, washing my hair.
Yes, it does look like he needs a good old wash.
With me asking you out, do you reckon it'd be a good idea if I asked your father's permission first?
Yes,
sure. Good evening, sir.
Hi.
So lovely ball, did you organise it yourself?
I did.
I have something important to ask you.
Go on.
It's about your daughter, who, may I add, is lovely. Yeah. I was wondering if I could take her out, please, sir.
Do you work?
Of course, I work with my father in his shop.
Of course you can.
Thank you, sir.
Evening.
You said yes.
Night, very nice night in a bang. banging. Would be the word.
Yeah, me too. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was alright.
So, can I see you again?
I'll see you around.
I'd love to.
Alright.
I'll see you next Thursday, 6.
Text me, babe.
Alright, see ya.
Sometimes, seen as a magical power, heart, or... Sometimes, seen as a magical power, heart, or a dark spirit, hypnotic language is actually very straightforward. Hypnotic language is designed to produce a hypnotic trance, since trance is simply highly status-focused of I'm gonna get this, I am. No fucker else is better than me. All right, Spike. Yeah, I'm waiting now. What do you think? I said I'm waiting. Mate, the guy's here. Yeah, yeah, I'll bring you back in.
Cheers, man.
Close friend?
Yeah, yeah.
Very well. So you want to be my right-hand man, eh? It's not easy, you know. What do you know about hypnosis?
I can hypnotize.
Don't try to run before you can walk. What do you know about it?
Not much, to be honest, but I can hypnotize. I'm a practical guy, do you know what I mean? Hypnosis is like a TV remote. The only difference is that we use what is called telemetry, which is pulses of sound waves to each other's brain to change thoughts, habits, or take control. Whereas a TV remote pulses of infrared to change settings or take control on the TV.
You have a lot to learn. I can say I was a teacher at the school you went to. I like you. That's why I'm going to give you a chance. But you've got to prove to me that you're worthy.
Yes, sir.
Would you use hypnosis to persuade me? Save your life. Cheat. Could you pass a test? Are you really that dark, Kyle?
How do you know my name?
As I said, I was a teacher at the school you went to.
Okay. So what do you want me to do?
Get out. Go on. Off you go.
Sorry?
Get out of my warehouse.
Last week.
3-mile member shot because you shot them and stole 25 kilos of oxy from my house. You know how much that shit costs.
I don't know what you're talking about.
They never do. Isn't that funny? Well, you've cost me 3 men and thousands of pounds that I can't replace. So today, you will die.
Slowly,
motherfucker.
What?
Wait, save your life. Chief, can you pass the test? Are you really that dark, Kyle?
Why are you looking at me like that? Stop it!
To pain, to pain, to pain, to pain.
Say again.
I'll explain. I'll use small words so I'll be sure to understand. To pain means the first thing you'll lose will be your feet below the ankles. Next, your hands at your wrists. Next, your nose.
And then my tongue, I suppose.
I wasn't finished. The next thing you will lose will be your left eye, followed by your right.
And then my ears, I understand. Let's get on with it.
Wrong. Your ears you keep, and I tell you why. So that everybody, including your family, can see you and comment on how bad you will look. Every woman who tries to approach you can say, "Dear God, what is that thing?"
Bullshit.
It's possible. I might be bluffing. It's conceivable. I'm only sitting here because I lack the strength to stand. Then again, if I tell you to stand up, you will. Won't you? To pain, or stand up? Would you use hypnosis to persuade me? Save your life. Chief, can you pass the test? Are you really that dark, Kyle? To pain, or swallow that full chorizo? Would you use hypnosis to persuade me? Save your life. Chief, can you pass the test? Are you really that dark, Kyle? To pain or choke? Language the most beautiful gift as a human, whether it is vocal, sign, or visual. Language is who we are. Take this time to get used to the dead. By the way, you passed your test. I'll see you tomorrow at 7.
Kick out.
Years ago, someone told me I should take caution when it comes to love. I did. I miss your smile. I still shed a tear.
And the hand that wrote this letter sweeps the pillow clean. So rest your head and read a treasured dream. Just stay strong. Because you know I'm here for you. Stay true to who you are.
I wish we could have another minute. The tallest mountain or the widest sea. Nothing's big enough to hide us.
And can't you see that I'm the one that understands you? You know, and I've been here all along. So why can't you see you belong with me? It's just stamping and you're shouting. I miss telling you off. My heart will let you go. I miss you.
All my love.
Mam.
Your wife, Hayley.
The woman who should be yours, Michelle.
Hi, Mum. Miss you. How's everything? Over here, everything's still the same. Yeah? Can't wait till I come back and see you again. Please, please don't worry about me. Okay? I'll be back before you know it. Miss you loads, Mummy. To my lovely affair. War is crazy and it made me think that what I've been doing is wrong. And I want it to end. I feel your frustration. But please, just have a little patience. And will you do me a favour? Keep this just in between us. I'll speak when I come back. Until then, keep it between us. To my lovely wife. Hey there, I miss you, as usual. Sometimes I wish we could have another life. Sometimes I wish I never left. I look at your pictures every day. And I feel this pain in my chest. I feel this pain in my chest and I just want to come back, I want to run away. I wish I could. I wish I had this. Since I was a kid, you know about this story. Since I was a kid, I wish I had a magic wand. And I could just say, let's go. I'll be there in less than 5 minutes and we'll come back. I'll see you soon. All my love. Gary.
Thank you.
trust you, you know. I feel like I can tell you anything, man. I mean, I can get. Can't I?
What?
I can tell you anything and trust you. Can't I?
Why would you want to tell me anything? You've only known me for a few hours.
Because you have this. The thing about you that seems to say you can trust me. So if I tell you something, can I trust you to do the right thing?
Yeah, sure. Got nothing better to do. Yeah, tell me anything.
Here, take this. What I want you to do is listen to my story and then make a decision.
What decision do I make?
If you think Wyatt was right, then you let me live. If you think Wyatt was wrong, then you shoot me.
I'm not sure about this.
Please, I need you to hear my story.
Okay.
Right, I haven't told this to anyone else before. I suppose I'd better start at the beginning. Do you think I should start at the beginning? Or should I just get right to the moment where it happens?
I don't mind. In fact, start from the beginning. Might as well tell me everything.
It was 10 years ago that I married my wife. I guess it's where we start, really. We barely knew each other. We just sort of rushed into this marriage. I loved her, though. It wasn't just for the sake of getting married that we did it. Because I really did like her. Well, anyway, we got married and everything's going fine. You know, had a few kids, bought our own house. Everything seemed to be just right. Can you guess what happens next in my story? Can you?
I don't know. Does someone die?
See, I meant what happens next. As in, the happy marriage, the kids and the house part.
I see. So someone does die in the end, then?
Yeah. Someone dies, all right.
Is it one of your kids? Does someone kill your children?
No. Nobody kills the children. Just wait.
I'm sorry. What happens next?
What happens next is that my wife, who supposedly loves me, turns out to be having an affair. What I mean is, my wife, my fucking wife, who I bought a house, a car, and most of all, her ring. That bitch. She cheats on me.
Who?
What do you mean, who?
Who's the one she cheated with? What was he called?
He was called David Crispin.
So that's the one who dies? He's the one you kill?
I didn't even know who he was. I haven't even met him. I just got his name. David Crispin. I despise that name. If I ever met David Crispin, I'd make him pay for what he did to me. He ruined my life.
All right, I see.
She told me herself, you know. One night we were having Chinese, and she comes out with it. I want a divorce. She says, I want a divorce because for the last year, I've been fucking this little bloke you don't know. And I'm going to marry him. See, he loves me. And I love him. He's kind, good looking, caring and rich. She actually said this to me. The ungrateful bitch, after all I have done for her.
Women.
She was no woman. She was a witch. Have you ever been in love?
Yeah.
And did it work out for you?
No, it was complicated.
Ah, shit in it. Do you know what she told me when I asked her why she cheated on me?
No.
She told me that my, and I quote, tiny prick wasn't big enough to satisfy her. That made me really angry.
But it did.
She told me this David Crispin guy was her soulmate. She had this snide look on her face. I saw her and said, fuck you. She said she was going to the house, the kids, and all her money with her. Stupidly, I let the house be put under her name. Even though I fucking paid for it. I'd left with nothing. And she knew it. So I had an option, really.
I mean, what would you do?
I don't know.
That night, she'd made me sleep in the car. I let things settle for a bit, until around 3 in the morning. And you should be asleep. So I went up to the house, let myself in with spare keys we keep in case of an emergency. I crept into the hallway. I'd made my way slowly up the stairs. Once I reached the top, I stopped and listened until I could hear her breathing lightly in her sleep. I tiptoed over to our bedroom door and pushed it slightly open. There she lay, that fucking bitch who had ruined my life. So I grabbed the paperweight that we kept next to our bed and smashed it into her fucking skull! She instantly started wiggling on the bed, so I had to put my hand over her mouth to stop her screaming. I kept whacking her skull till she became motionless. I watched with fascination as she laid there, rasping for breath, her eyes wide open, begging for mercy. After I smashed her skull to the point it even looked human, I began to run. I've been running all these years under various false names. The police won't find me, not ever. See, my current name is just Stephen. I work in the post office. Ironic, really. My real name is Tony Buckley. So there you go. That's my story. I told you it because I can trust you to do the right thing. I mean, I really trust you. You just have this vibe about you that seems to say you can trust me.
You already said that.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Well, it's true. Anyway, have you made a decision as to what my fate should be?
Well, I've made my decision, all right. I made it before we started telling the story.
What decision have you made?
You didn't think I'd do it, did you? You think I'd feel sorry for you?
Well, I don't! I admit, I didn't expect you to kill me. But I don't particularly mind you shooting me. You are, after all, an innocent man with nothing wrong. Your judgment of me is fair and biased.
You don't get it, do you?
Get what?
Why, you so wrapped up in yourself, you never once asked me who I was. You never once asked my name.
What is your name?
I'm David Crispin.
Notepad
out.
Notepad.
Or pen.
Notepads and pens.
Yeah. Is that too hard to do?
Well, it's a bit of a flex, you know. You just got to try and. It's a bit hard to try and get it.
People call it so easy. When I was in school, we had to be stupid and booing every day. Bring our own equipment.
And who cares?
Is that too hard to do? Yeah. You both got attention.
Shit.
No. 30 minutes of my break wasted. Oh my god.
loser.
Play again.
Oh, sorry, sir. Yeah, I just went to McDonald's, picked myself up a 99p cheeseburger.
As you do.
As you do. Oh, God. No, wait, what?
When?
Why is everyone doing work and stuff?
What?
Oh, look at that pretty little pencil case.
Oh, look at
that pretty little pencil case.
Oh,
it's cute.
You two, no whispering in my classroom.
Why is everyone doing work and like...
No idea, look at them all.
Everyone's changed, we're like in uniform and shit.
Yeah. You've got something to say? Come to the front of my classroom and sing it. You didn't wear outside to address you to come into the classroom. You have no intention of doing any work. You're dressed inappropriately and you brought food into my classroom.
Style.
Ever so nervous. He sat all night fretting and worrying over his grades. Eventually he nodded off at his writing desk at gone 6 in the morning. He had to be up at 7:30. Harold, I said. Harold, it's time to get up, darling. Nothing. Not even a twitch. Darling, I said, shaking him. This time I got a mumbled. So I tried again. Harold, it's gone 7:30. Don't be late for the interview. He was motionless for a second. And only a second. Then he leapt out of the chair and shouted,
"Oh, crikey!"
B4 tripping over the rug.
"I've got to go, Mother."
"Yes, I know, darling."
"My exam's held, Mother."
"Yes, I know. Don't fret. I'm sure you passed."
"You're sure?"
"Yes. Darling, let me come with you. I know how important it is that you pass the woodwork exam, and I want to be there for you." I didn't expect him to say yes to my coming along with him. I knew how nervous he was.
"No, I'm sorry, Mother, but I must do this alone. Why, I'm a fully grown man now. And those days of relying on you for help are over. I can survive in the world, Mother. Just you wait and see."
And with that and a quick
tinkety-tonk,
off he went. Only to return moments later saying,
"Dash it! Still got me damn gym jams on."
2 minutes later, after I helped him into his shirt and jacket, he was gone and on his way to pick up his important results. I do hope he's done well. So nervous. Did you pass, darling?
Did I pass? Did I pass, you say? Mother, I not only passed, but I got the best grades in my whole year.
That's wonderful! Absolutely wonderful! How do you feel?
How do I feel? Well, I feel wonderful, marvellous and splendid all at the same time.
Mind the carrots, darling.
Sorry, Mother.
Have you told Vera?
No, not yet.
Well, go and tell her before your father gets back.
Ah, yes, now, Mother.
Yes?
Vera.
Yes, sorry?
About Vera, I mean.
What about her?
Oh, well, here's the thing. Last week, I sort of asked her to marry me. So, there you go!
I see. Well, I can't say I'm surprised. What did she say?
She said yes.
Oh, that's wonderful!
You're not cross?
Not at all. Like you said yourself, you're a fully grown man now. I'm so delighted. Oh, I can hear 5 in the hallway. Go and tell him.
Oh, blast you, leave me alone. Oh, confound you. Oh, yes!
Stanley!
Oh, it's you.
Well, who else would it be? I mean, you hardly ever have visitors here. Apart from me, of course. You know, some people a few months back thought you died! Anyway, here I am. Can
Can I come in?
No.
Oh, well, maybe another time. I just came to tell you that I'm moving away.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you.
No need to be like that, Stan. You know perfectly well that I love and would move in with you, if only you would give me the chance.
And you know that I've only ever loved one woman in my entire life.
Oh, she's dead, Stan. It's been nearly 20 years and you're still mourning. It's time to move on.
I've had enough. Go!
I'm sorry, Stan.
Go, I say.
Well done, son. Jolly good. Engage with a certain chance of getting a job, a nice family home, and maybe even the sound of tiny pattering feet.
Steady on!
One thing at a time, dear, please.
I feel all right, though. I feel like my life's all there, right in front of me, just waiting to happen. I feel like I'm about to start on this wonderful journey that they call life.
I am speaking to you from the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently this country is at war with Germany.
I really wouldn't know. Look, what do you want?
Look, it's not my decision, but a young man had his house bombed. He's got nothing. And they want you to take him in until he's recovered from his injuries.
What? I've lost enough in the last bloody war. I'm having nothing to do with this one.
Well, you have this empty house.
I like it empty.
Stop being so selfish. You have no choice, Dad. I'm sorry. You'll be sent paperwork at a later date. I must go.
Then, boy. Well, Harold, why are you talking like that?
Shock
from what?
Bomb.
I see. Can you make the stairs, boy? Jesus. You can stay here tonight in this chair. Are you hungry? Okay, well, I'm going to have some food and then go to bed. Good night. Do you want some tea?
Please.
There you go. Careful, let me help you. I don't know how long you're going to be here, and I don't particularly want you to be here, but there you go. I'll try to make the best of things, so today we're going to get you back on your feet. If I'm going to have you living under my roof, I should be able to talk to you, so today we're going to get you talking again, okay? Okay. Right. Give me the first word, boy.
Shall.
Come on, keep going.
Shall I come?
Yes, come on.
Shall I compare the to a shall I compare thee to a summer's day?
Good, repeat that line.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Shall I compare thee to a summer's day?
Excellent, next line.
That thou art
come on. Go back to the first line.
Shall I compare thee to a shall I compare thee?
You just did it, come on! You stupid boy! Don't come round here destroying my stuff! Your house may be gone, but mine is still here! Foxtail suit, my boy. There you go. Look, I'm sorry for shouting at you. I know things have been pretty rough for you. See? I tend not to let people into my life. Not since Hilda died. She was my wife and my soulmate, and we were very happy together. But like you with your family, I lost her due to this war. This house was bombed, and I rebuilt it myself. And I've never let anyone in till you arrived. This house and that book is all I have left of her.
Sorry.
Oh, it's okay, my boy. I could do with someone around the place, throwing my books around.
Thank you.
It's okay, my boy. Good to see you're talking again.
Yeah, I was stupid, really. I don't want to die, just need to grow up.
Do you know, my boy, you're not so bad.
They grew closer over the next few months, like father and son. Harold never forgot his parents, but he did begin to move on and live his life with Stan. He got in touch with Vera, they even managed to meet up a few times and wrote to each other every week. They were still very much in love, and although there was no house, job, or pattering of tiny feet, they knew one day things would be all right again. Harold had started walking again a few weeks after moving in with Stan. Things were looking out for both of them. Stanley was, for the first time since Hilda, letting someone into his life again. He had accepted that not everyone would be lost in life, and in Stanley he saw hope for his future. The war did not trouble them much out in the country, and when troubling thoughts set in, they had each other to confide in and would feel comforted to talk to one another. It was almost a year later in summer when yet again, the curse of the war was waiting.
Now, I've got it all, man.
Thank you very much. What is it?
It's a letter.
A letter? Who on earth is writing to me? This is odd.
Well, it's to me, actually.
Ah, Vera.
No.
Even more odd.
May I say Stan?
What is it, my lad?
This letter.
What about it?
It's from the army.
Oh God, what does it say?
Now that I'm physically able, I'm to sign up and go to war there. They're coming to collect me this afternoon. I'm sorry, Stan.
Oh God.
What is it?
I like having you here, Harold. You're all I have to live for. You're like the son I never had.
I'm sorry, old man, but when this war is over, I'll come back to you, I promise.
You'd better do.
I say, Stan, they're here.
Okay. Off you go then, boy. Let yourself out.
Aren't you going to let me out?
I can't. Please, just go. Let's pretend you're just going out for the milk.
I'm not though, am I?
Please, just go.
Okay, well, I'll miss you.
A few months passed, and Stan heard nothing. Then one day in November, Stan received a letter.
Hi, Stan. It's Harold. If you're reading this, then I've died. War is bleak and miserable. I dream of Vera. I dream of peace. I want to come home. Stan, if I have died, and you are reading this, then tell Vera I love her, will you? Thanks. Not just for that, but for taking me in and looking after me. I haven't forgotten you, old man. I hope you're well. All my love, Harold. P.S. Sorry you never got the milk.
Of
the Art of the English Language.
Thank you, Saxon. Now remember, if you would like more information on any of our stories, or if you would like to receive some stunning updates, then please feel free to visit the website at www.timeline.com. That is
www.timeline.com.
Thank you, Saxon. You can also like our page on Facebook, or you may tweet us on Twitter, or whatever you do in our days. Anyway, we will be back at the same time tomorrow for another broadcast and more updates. I've been Angela.
And I've been Saxon.
And this has been Time 9 News with the Art of the English Language. Have a nice day. Goodbye for now.
Thank you.